Hello there everybody, welcome back to another video, and in today's video let's talk about Hacktoberfest 2023. So in brief, Hacktoberfest is an event organized by DigitalOcean every year to encourage us developers to contribute to open source projects and value those contributions as well. And usually every year developers go participate in this Hacktoberfest, and then they go find open source repositories where they can contribute and make those projects better with their contribution and make their GitHub profile and make their own knowledge better by contributing to those repositories. So let's begin taking a look at this website. Now, if you look at this website in the first glance, it looks perfect because it has a new theme every year, and this theme also looks very nice with the gold and blue color. I'll put the link of this website in the description below. You can check this out for yourself. And you can go through, read it, you can see how you can participate. Basically, to participate, you just need to register from September 26 to October 31. And it starts at the 1st of October. From 1st of October to 31st of October, any pull request you make will be counted in Hacktoberfest. And the accepted pull requests will be counted as well. So an accepted pull request has some criteria, that is, one, the repository or the project should have the Hacktoberfest topic, so basically a label on the repository that yes, it is eligible for Hacktoberfest. Next, it should be merged, or it should have sort of a label that okay, it is accepted for Hacktoberfest. Now, if you have got 4 merged pull requests before 31st of October, you can go ahead and plant a tree through Tree Nation. Now, usually in the past Hacktoberfest, what happened is all of the developers, not all, but the first 50,000 participants who did this task got a t-shirt as a reward. And this was very nice, except the people who tried to abuse Hacktoberfest by trying to make spam pull requests, by trying to fix nothing in a repository in an open source project, which then led to a lot of controversies, which I'm not going to get into. But now they have removed the t-shirt reward, which is fine in my opinion. They did it because of some logistics issue, but I don't mind that at all because we plant a tree anyways. Next up, let's talk about what's the benefit of this. Now, when you go ahead and go to an open source project or repository, and then you just go ahead and find something, some issue, you find a bug, or you think about a feature that can be added, and you just go ahead and add it, your knowledge improves. So you think about the problem and then you think of the solution. Now that is basically engineering. That's how software works. Even if it's not your project, it's someone else's project. So they get the benefit for their project, and you also get the benefit of learning from doing those tasks. The other benefit of participating in Hacktoberfest is the publicity you can get. So you can go ahead and tell everyone, I participated in Hacktoberfest, I got this, I got that. You also get digital rewards, which is basically some perks that you get when you participate in Hacktoberfest. For example, this badge board. Now, I know this is not something very big or outstanding, but it shows that you did something valuable. Next up, when you make pull requests, when you contribute to an open source project, it reflects that on your GitHub profile. And GitHub is the best proof of work you can give to someone. You can just give your GitHub profile to someone and say, this is what I have done. When they see that how much pull requests you've opened, how much projects there are that you have contributed to, when they see this green chart, the chances of you getting accepted as a developer are very high. Now, if you are a beginner in all this, if you don't know what is Git and what is GitHub, but you know some coding, right? What you can do is you can learn Git and GitHub from Nick White. He made a short video that's about 20 minutes long. It's about Git and GitHub, and it's the best tutorial, or I would say the best crash course that I have found. So it's the best place to start. I'll leave the link in the description below as well as in the info button up above. So first, go ahead and learn Git and GitHub. It will take time because it's something new, but it is the most crucial thing that you need to know as a developer. Now let's talk about how you can find projects. About 2 years back, I made this project called Hacktoberfest Finder, or Hacktoberfest Projects, something like this that I called it. And in the last 2 years, it has evolved so much due to all of your contributions. We changed the theme from 2021 to 22, and then now to 23, I changed the theme according to what the theme is right over here. And so what you can do is you can simply go ahead and select a language. So for instance, let's select TypeScript. That's my programming language. And then I can go ahead and find all these repositories. Now, in the first glance, you will find very big projects that you probably would not want to contribute to. I mean, how can you contribute to Nest.js, right? So what you can do is you can go ahead and sort according to, for example, most help wanted issues. So when you go ahead and sort it with this, and then again, you will find big projects. You can also sort it from the stars. So you see these repository stars, right? 16,000. So that means it's a big repository. What you can do is you can say, okay, I want show me repositories from 100 to 200 stars. When I hit search on that, what you'll see is, okay, this looks nice, knowledge-based content. So that contains some stuff. You can also make no-code contributions by creating issues or something like that. Also, you see this repository's last commit was last month, and there are a lot of issues that are open. So you can go ahead and go through all these issues, or you can find, you can go to their project, and then you can find, okay, what can be improved here, or what a bug is that I can fix. For example, this scroll bar that you see, you can fix this as a bug, and you can go to their code and fix it if you know the technology. So that is basically how you can find projects. Now, if you want to know how you can actually contribute to a project, I already made a video about it. I'll link it up and down in the description below as well. The only condition, the sole condition that should be, now there are a few conditions for a repository to get accepted, but this is the main condition, that is the Hacktoberfest topic. So this topic or this label should be on the repository so that your pull request gets counted for it. Also, you can go ahead and contribute to this project as well by clicking on the GitHub icon right over here, and you can open this repository. You can contribute to this one as well. Many people did, and all their names are listed on this page. So you can go ahead and contribute to this repository as well. I would love to review your contributions, and I hope you make yourself better in this Hacktoberfest. Don't make spam pull requests that are of no use. Make useful contributions that actually add value to the project as well as in your knowledge. I hope this video helped you out. Let me know any questions you have down in the comments below. And finally, thanks for watching.